Well, hello there. In this video, I'm going to show you how to take a letter set in a different language and map it to your keyboard so you can type in those letters and make embroidery designs. So this started when I got an email from Salha, who wanted to take this set of letters in Hebrew and map them in Embrilliance so that they operated like a BX font. So she sent me these files, and these are all just folders full of individual designs, and each of these are individual characters, and each set is a different size. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to hop over to Embrilliance, and I'm going to click on this letter button right here. It says import font. It will only appear if you own AlphaTricks. So let's click on it. And it says, would you like to begin importing a font? Well, yes, I would. So we'll say yes. And I'm going to select this. We'll start with the largest set. And these are all of the characters. And I'm going to say select all. And I'm going to say import. Okay, now Embrilliance doesn't know what character to map these to. But these are basically in order. I did notice that each set has 27 characters and the English language has 26 characters. So I'm off probably in my mapping. But if you knew Hebrew, you'd be able to figure it out. So I have this first character selected here. And if I look over on my cheat sheet, that looks like the letter A to me. And then the next one is B. So I'm going to go ahead and tell Embrilliance that this is capital A. And it jumped over to the next one and it's B. So I'm just gonna assume that all of these are in order, which they probably aren't. LMNOPQRSTDXYZ. And if you have another character that doesn't match, doesn't map to an English character, we can always use a number or some piece of punctuation or something so that we can access that character through our keyboards. And like I said, I don't know if I did this perfectly, but this is just to give you a quick idea of how to do this. So let's go and say save font. Not all designs are mapped. I know, because I don't know what that character means, but we'll just say yes. And I'm going to say, I'm going to give it a name that I want it to be, and I'm going to say Hebrew 0.6 inches. Save. Yes, I should have named it before I saved it, so now I probably saved it twice, but that's okay. So we can go ahead and close this, and once I close it, then I can go over to Embrilliance, just use my lettering tool, and now I should be able to find it right here. And I can type my name if I want. And that's my name in Hebrew, I think. I don't know about the mapping, but you should know. Now every time I start up Embrilliance, that will be there. I would go ahead and do this with all of the different sizes that I have. And then, like I said, it just stays with Embrilliance. Of course, if you were to change computers, there's a process for importing and exporting and then re-importing all your BX fonts, but let's not worry about that for now. The bottom line is that we can type in Hebrew. So I hope you found this to be useful. If you're interested in more Embrilliance information, subscribe to my channel. I also have some courses on Embrilliance, or send me a message. Maybe you have a question that I can answer. Thanks.